there's a text message that you answer about 24 hours later. You are the slowest person on text
I've ever seen. Well, hey, I've got things to do. I'm going to text you back about a picture. I'll text you back about, hey, this happened. What do you think? Then I'll text you back.
I want to be text back about every detail.
Okay, from now on, done.
Every detail
done,
I got to have.
Deal, done.
Most All right, so in, the world. In relationships, it's tough. I mean, it's really hard to find the right mix. And you might go for a few years and then realize it's the wrong one.
I agree. But it's okay. It's not necessarily the wrong one. It was the right one then.
Right one for the moment. Good for now, girl.
Or the good for that time in your life person or guy.
Yeah.
And now you've changed or now they've changed and you move on.
And you move on. And I also think for us, I think the best places to meet people are probably the gyms.
I think they are because, God, you're seeing people in their most honest behavior because, like, for girls, a lot of times, you're in there at the crack of dawn, no makeup.
Yeah.
Big sweats, whatever.
Who's Dawn?
Dawn, as in D-O-N or D-A-W-N.
Are you talking about a lady? You said the crack
of
dawn.
I don't know, depends. Whatever works for you.
Oh, I took that wrong when you said the crack.
Okay, whatever. So anyways, though, I'm just saying that you see people at their, if they're losing weight, you see them at their heaviest and then starting to trim down.
That's very true.
And that's just sometimes exactly what attracts you to someone.
Yeah.
Sometimes you end up being like really having really honest conversations because you're next to them on the treadmill.
That's true.
And it's three, in the afternoon and neither of you's got a job and you end up having an hour talk and all of a sudden you went on a date. So to me, it's a very naked place in a way.
Yeah.
Because you're at your most vulnerable. People are seeing you in that physical,
That's very true. And I consider that workout next to him as with the first date anyway, so that's already out of the way.
Oh, it's done.
It's done.
Then you're not going to kiss on the end of that date.
I get a hug.
Yeah, probably.
And they always make an excuse. I'm so sweaty. And I said, that's fine. I like it.
But it's not even an excuse. It is that we're self-conscious. Like, I always say that because I actually want you to know that I acknowledge.
Yeah, you're the one that tells me that.
Yeah, I always go. I always say, oh, I'm disgusting and sweaty.
Yeah, we like that.
You
like
mind?
We all want to play slip and slide.
You're hoping that it's actually going to translate to something else at some point.
It will.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I like that. Confidence is also
good.
It's
not a matter of how hard you work out and how much time you put in. It's who you shower with.
It's I will not argue with that point.
Well, of course.
I will
and
not
I bring my own soap.
And you don't bend over for it, though, do you?
Well, not in Gold's Gym, I don't. No.
You shouldn't.
I back against the wall.
You definitely
on that
don't
place.
Want to.
No, I won't do that. I don't even shower there. I come home and do it. Well, that's a little bit about what I wanted to talk about, but I want to do more episodes on relationships, and we'll do more on fitness and diet and workouts, and we're going to do some Rick's Tips of the Week, because we do still have to do that, and we haven't. But,
yeah, we haven't done any of the stuff in the gym.
Because I can't ever pin you down. I text you, and you're like gone for 5 days.
You can pin me down.
Yeah, I'm going to pin you down.
You can pin me down.
So I want to thank you guys for watching this today because it was a whole new episode for Tough and Tender. Remember, you got a tough side and you got to show your tender side because women like the tender side.
We love the tender side, especially if there's a tough guy there.
Exactly.
Oh,
it's good to be
that.
A bad boy on the outside, but inside you got to have some heart.
That's right.
And we have a little visitor that's been bugging us all day. Come here, Bogart. Come here.
No, he doesn't want to come.
No, he'll come. Come up here. There we go. Let me get you up here. Oh, God. So he's...
Look at this. Precious gem.
He's been dying to sit
Hi,
up here with
sweetie,
us
poo-poo.
And be a part of the camera.
Look at him, he smells
this
good.
This is Bogart. I had him on once
Bogart.
Before.
He's
just a sweetheart. But I don't like when he licks my face after licking his tukas.
I don't care. Yeah, I'm gross like that.
All
Sorry.
Right, so thanks for staying in tune for Rick's Corner and stay tuned for the next one. Manuela and I will be here with Bogey.
Bogey. Guests.